having the vision to achieve something is very important. Many individuals in the whole world started from nothing and are now set at unbelievable heights. Celebrities, entrepreneurs, scientists, and much more. If you look for yourself, you'll find many examples of people who have a passion for getting something in life and have done that after untiring efforts. Have you heard of anyone who's not so intelligent and a weak student and then turned out to be a classical success? If not, you're gonna hear it today. David W. Anderson was a weak student and learner, but he followed his passion for smoked meat, and now his business is covering 1,800 premium locations nationwide. Today, we'll discuss every area of David W. Anderson's, or Famous Dave's, journey, his achievements, and how he managed all of those things. Be with us until the end, and we promise you'll enjoy every second of this video. Remember to give the video a like and subscribe for content like this. Here we go. Dave Anderson grew up far from the traditional epicenters of barbecue, but his passion for it was still sparked when his father arrived home with barbecue from street vendors in Chicago. Southern-style Chi-Town's competitive barbecue scene featured massive smokers serving up ribs so delicious that eating them became an Anderson family tradition. It could be the family bond, the spicy smoked food, or both, but Anderson found his calling, and it called him to the next level of barbecue. A passion was kindled in those Southside smokers that burned brighter and brighter, until finally extinguished by his future franchises. Thanks to his father's fateful decisions about food, Anderson found his North Pole. From then on, Anderson embarks on a journey to bring bona fide barbecue to the rest of the country. Famous Anderson is brilliant at the barbecue, but very weak in studies. He never enjoys good grades and always stays at the bottom of the class. Moreover, he had ADD at the time and was the prime suspect of bullying by others. He somehow survived high school, but he was solid mentally. He pushed himself and worked great to achieve roaring success later. Dave wasn't obsessed with studies or learning, but had other plans. He was obsessed with barbecues, and his ambition made him successful. Dave Anderson proved that daydreaming could be changed into reality if one has the guts to do it. Every success begins with passion. Dave's case isn't different. Dave spent a very long part of his life, approximately 25 years, searching for the best barbecue all over the country. Moving from one spot to another, one city to another, he checked out every eating point from Chicago to Kansas City, the high hills of Georgia and Carolina, and ended at the pits of Texas. He tasted the barbecue from different places to improve his recipe. Then he concluded that there's only one way to make the best barbecue, to make it traditionally, but with Southern spices. He has this vision in mind that someday this will make his barbecue famous all over. And after that, he announced himself with the first franchise of Famous Dave. Isn't this amazing how David gave 25 years of his life to his passion and achieved his goal in life? Let us know in the comments what you guys think of Dave's passion and if it is right to give that much time to your passion. Dave Anderson is a man with a long spine. Considering all the hurdles and risks in his way, he opened his first restaurant in Wisconsin in 1994. This was a risky project, but with Dave's abilities, he made it a huge success. There were odds, but he buckled up against them and proved that he was a man with hard liver by opening a prominent restaurant in a small city in the first place. Dave has won over 700 awards for his smoked meat barbecue. There's no one in the history of the world who has received that much applause and recognition, which Dave enjoyed. In the American Barbecue Sauce Contest, Dave received the famous People's Choice for Best Ribs in America award. Again, this prolific number of medals reflects Anderson's dedication to the craft, which shines through his idea of Famous Dave's barbecue. A byproduct of studying the greatest smokehouses and following your culinary dreams with unrelenting passion. Anderson's greatness is also contagious, as other members of the Famous Dave's team have also racked up accolades. Dave Anderson has not just received some local awards, but his success has touched the Hall of Fame. The jury of the Hall of Fame believe that Dave Anderson is genuinely worthy of the Native American Hall of Fame, as he rightly understands the difficulties faced by the natives in schools and other communities. He's not limited to barbecue, but has joined several bureaus and boards of awards to make a difference and improve things. He heads the Bureau of Indian Affairs and has chaired several committees aimed at helping minority businesses. A list of giving backs grows as Anderson continues in philanthropy and business. for these philanthropic acts and many others, Anderson's work has been recognized by the Native American community. On November 8, 2021, he was inducted into the Native American Hall of Fame by Gary Batten, chief of the Choctaw Nation of Oklahoma. Tragedy and losses are part of everyone's life. It just happens at some time suddenly and leaves everyone awestruck in huge loss. Such a massive incident happened with Famous Dave in the year 2014. The first location of Famous Dave in Wisconsin Round Lake caught fire in the middle of the night after 20 years of its inception. The fire brigade and other crew reached the site, but it was too late. The fire was recorded at 50 feet high and burned down everything. Luckily, there was no human loss as the restaurant was closed and no employees were there. The worst thing was that the fire happened just before the holiday season, leaving more than 60 employees in shock and lurch. The tragic loss affected Dave Anderson profoundly, and he parted ways with Famous Dave and later looked to start his barbecue joint after some time. He has not agreed with the terms and has thought of starting a new setup. After separating ways with Famous Dave after the fire incident, Dave Anderson returned to Jimmy's old Southern Smokehouse. Dave worked there and soon raised it to new heights. But after some time, Famous Dave Brass and Dave Anderson agreed and removed their differences. And as a result, Jimmy's old Southern Smokehouse started to incorporate under the flagship of Famous Dave. The middle of 2010 was not a banner year for Famous Dave. Beginning in the second quarter of fiscal 2013, sales at Famous Dave's declined quarter over quarter. This poor performance led to branch closures nationwide, which drove their stock price below $5 per share. Famous Dave's was cornered and had to find a way out. Putting differences aside to move to the future, Famous Dave's brought Anderson back in 2015, a year after they parted ways. In 2019, they unveiled the new parent company, BBQ Holdings, and shook up their floor plans. As the changes began to take hold, the company's future took a hit. The pandemic has changed Dave's plans, and he's now focused on moving with quick turnaround and more drive-through things. Much of Famous Dave's revival came through the restructuring of their new parent company, BBQ Holdings. BBQ Holdings brought back a healthier bottom line through several acquisitions as part of the restructuring. According to Nation's Restaurant News, it has acquired barbecue conglomerate Granite City Food and Brewery and barbecue restaurant Real Urban. BBQ Holdings, which rescued Granite City Food and Brewery from bankruptcy, plans to keep its acquired brewery chain recognizable while allowing Granite City Food and Brewery's offerings to make their way into Famous Dave's, according to Nation's Restaurant News. As the world has changed post-pandemic, the biggest flex of BBQ Holdings' corporate muscle may have been its push to acquire several buffet chains. That's all from Famous Dave's barbecue passion story. The whole untold story of David Anderson teaches us that if one has the passion and hunger to hold on to something big in life, then someday one will get it. David struggled for 25 years and stood out as a mountain until he got what he had envisioned. What about you guys? What do you like the most? Smoked meat or another one? Do you think we need to stick to our passion for that long a period? Let us know in the comments and share your honest opinions. Do subscribe to our channel to view more of our incredible videos. And hit the bell icon to remain updated about all our future videos. See you all next time.